This is Alan and Kathy. Alan is in the hospital. 3 days ago, he was not able to speak or move the right side of his body at all. His wife, Kathy, noted the changes in her husband and called 911. He was brought to the emergency room within an hour after his speech and strength difficulties began. In the emergency room, he was given a clot-busting medication called TPA. He is now able to speak a few words. Despite this, he understands everything that his doctors, nurses, and wife share with him. He is now able to walk with the help of a walker and with someone by his side. He is not able to open and close his right hand. Before his stroke, he would spend his time in his workshop making toys for his 3 grandchildren and reading with Kathy on their front porch. On Wednesdays, Alan would go bowling with 2 of his good friends and his son, Johnny. The doctors talked to Alan and Kathy about what can put people at risk for having another stroke and how to help him recover as much as possible from his stroke.
Alan and Kathy, risk factors for stroke include high blood pressure, diabetes, high cholesterol, atrial fibrillation, blockage in the carotid arteries, cigarette smoking, drinking too much alcohol, physical inactivity, obesity, and finally, obstructive sleep apnea.
I know my Alan has had high blood pressure and he takes his water pill every day for that. His doctor in clinic says his blood pressure looks good for the most part, with a couple readings here and there that are higher than where we'd like them to be. He has been on blood thinner for his atrial fibrillation, and he takes all his medicines every day. We've heard of OSA before. Our son Johnny has it. He used to snore so badly and was tired all the time before he found out he had it. Now Johnny doesn't snore anymore and has endless energy. Alan and I have been married for 52 years and he does not snore. And before a couple days ago, he was always so active.
You both bring up good points. Let's talk more about OSA. OSA occurs when people are sleeping. When we sleep, our body relaxes. That also includes the muscles in the back of our throat. When the muscles relax, it causes the soft tissue in the back of the throat to collapse and block the airway. This can cause people to stop breathing, which in turn causes oxygen levels to fall to unsafe levels. The brain knows when our body stops breathing, and the brain wakes our body up just enough to unblock the airway, but not enough to fully wake us up. This cycle happens hundreds of times every night. Sometimes people may snore. Sometimes people may even be sleepy the next day because of this. We don't know why, but folks like you that have survived a stroke, they may not snore. They may not even feel sleepy. They think their sleep is A-okay. Anywhere between 60 and 80% of people that have had a stroke have OSA. And OSA, when it's not treated, makes it more likely that someone will have another stroke.
So you're saying that even though Alan doesn't have the same problems as Johnny with OSA, Alan could still have OSA?
Yes, that's correct. I should also mention a few more things about why getting tested for OSA is so important for stroke survivors. Not only is OSA a risk factor for stroke, it could also make some risk factors harder to control, including high blood pressure and atrial fibrillation, which you have.
We see.
Also, if we find that you have OSA in the next couple of days or weeks, and we start treating you, Alan, it could also improve how much speech and strength you recover after your stroke.
Could you please tell us more about that? My Alan was so active up until a couple days ago. We all want him to get better.
Absolutely. When we find that a stroke survivor has OSA, and we treat their OSA soon after their stroke, they experience improved symptom recovery from their stroke as compared to the stroke survivors with OSA who don't get treatment.
So, doctor, you're saying that if Alan does suffer from OSA and we treat him soon, then he is less likely to have another stroke and he's more likely to better recover from his stroke.
Yes, that's it exactly. We can even test him in the hospital or soon after he goes to the rehabilitation center.
Honey, what do you think? Do you want to get the sleep test?
Yes, please, as soon as possible.